Welcome friends to an honest review of a beautiful product, the Moto G5S Plus launched in late August 2017. This review is literally done after actually using the product for over 15 days now. With that being said, let's get started. So this phone comes in nice minimalistic packaging. I have already shared the unboxing experience. In case you wish to check it out, I will link it at the very end of this video and in the description box down below. Moving now, first important aspect of this review, the design. This is big elegant looking phone built with extreme quality. The design, if you look from front to back, looks amazing. There is not a single plastic element here compared to the G5. This feels high end and premium. The Moto G5S Plus smartphone comes with slightly curved back panel and rounded edges. The front remains dominated by the 5.5 inch full HD display and has a home screen button with integrated fingerprint sensor. On top of the display, there is a selfie camera, LED flash and earpiece placed. The top of the front panel also has a Moto branding on it. On flipping the phone over, you see non-removable black panel, which is completely made of metal. It has dual rear camera setup which protrudes out and also features antenna band running on top and on bottom. Right in the center of the back panel lies the Motorola dimple. The volume rocker and power buttons are sandwiched on the right edge, while the SIM tray is placed on the left edge of the smartphone. At the very bottom, you see micro USB port and the speaker grills, while at the top, there is a 3.5mm audio jack. Also, because dual rear cameras protrude out, one has to be very careful while placing the device on any surface as there is always a chance of damaging the lens. A few flaws aside, the design of the smartphone and the good build quality left me suitably impressed. The display. The display of the smartphone is certainly worth talking about. The Moto G5S Plus comes with 5.5 inch full HD 1080p display with cornering Gorilla Glass 3 on top. It showed bright vibrant color and noticed no pixelation. There was no strain on my eyes when the device was used in dim light conditions. Even the sunlight legibility of the smartphone is commendable. Images appeared sharp, but the colors were a bit saturated. But other than that, we could not find any other flaw. The Moto G5S Plus display is unquestionably the major highlight of the phone. Performance and battery life. Powered by 2GHz octa-core Qualcomm Snapdragon 625 SoC coupled with 4GB RAM, the smartphone offers 64GB of internal storage and can also hold microSD card of up to 128GB. Moto G5S Plus runs Android 7.1.1 Nougat out of the box and has minor Motorola exclusive software enhancement. With the combination of octa-core processor, add in 4GB of RAM, 64GB of internal storage, stock Android of 7.1.1, the performance of Motorola G5S Plus does not disappoint. It works smoothly during the time I used it and never showed any lag or slowdown. Multitasking on this phone, whether I am listening to music, playing games, watching YouTube, using Google Map for navigation, was flawless. The Moto G5 Plus handled it all with utmost ease. The fingerprint sensor of the device is a big plus. There wasn't a single time during my use when it took more than one attempt to unlock the device. The Moto G5S Plus has 3000mAh battery on board. With moderate daily usage, you can expect a 2-day battery life easily. Check out my usage where I have charged it about 1 day and 10 hours ago and now I have 39% remaining, which can go for another 20 hours. In case you are a heavy user and play a lot of games, do expect a 1-day battery life out of this phone. Also add in the turbocharging capabilities of the phone that can provide up to 6 hours of battery life with just 15 minutes of charge. Moving on to the most important feature and the upgrade according to Motorola, the camera. The Indian market is filling up with dual camera smartphones and the Moto G5S Plus is the latest one to join the club. There are two 13-megapixel sensors with f2.0 aperture and a color-correcting dual LED flash. It performs well enough, though it did take some effort to get the shots right. Unlike the Xiaomi Mi A1, the dual cameras on Moto G5S Plus took some getting used to, as I missed many shots on the first attempt. You can refine the shots with post-processing, but it still requires some effort. Depth shot in good lighting appears to have nice blurred background, but the edges of the foreground subjects aren't always well defined. Also, sometimes it misses the main object completely. On the other hand, the Moto G5S Plus seems more capable when it comes to low light photography. I was able to capture some decent depth shot in low light with good amount of details and well controlled noise. Regular shot in good lights have natural and good textures, landscapes are exposed well and colors are accurate. The HDR mode does a really good job of maintaining highlight details in shots that have uniform lighting, but we did notice overexposure at times in shot with differently lit areas. I believe the Moto G5S Plus does better in low light than most of its current competition. The front 8-megapixel camera is your selfie shooter and the images are good and clear. If you are someone who loves uploading selfie in social media, just turn on the beautification feature and the self-portraits would turn out to be much better. Miscellaneous feature. The Moto G5S Plus has 64GB of storage, which is expandable using the micro SD card of up to 128GB. This is done using a hybrid dual SIM slots with two nano SIM slots, one of which can be shared with the micro SD slot. Connectivity options on the smartphone includes 4G, Wi-Fi, Bluetooth 4.2, GPS, micro USB and a 3.5mm audio jack. Yes, you can use your GeoSIMs in any slot and it works fine. The smartphone weighs 168 grams and feels little on the heavier side. The only feature which is missing here is an LED notification light. Final verdict. Moto G5S Plus comes with its own sets of pros and cons, but the positive of the device definitely outweighs the negative. It has an elegant design, a good build quality and reasonably good display. Performance-wise, it runs smoothly and has an excellent fingerprint sensor. The camera and the sound output could have been little better, but at ₹15,999, the smartphone delivers what it promises. The Moto G5S Plus is certainly a good buy and look like it will carry the Motorola legacy in this price segment. I hope I could bring you a justified and an honest review. In case you have any question, please tweet me for getting an instant response at GameTechHD. Do hit the like button in case you have stayed this far with me. Please subscribe to this channel to support me and never miss out on any of my future contents. Until next time, stay safe and stay healthy. Thank you.